Hey guys, so in this video I'm going to show you how to simplify equations using the multiplication and division methods. All right, so when multiplying, you want to expand by adding in the hidden multiplication signs, stuff that we did in week one, and group the numbers and variables together, and then you just multiply everything back together. All right, when dividing, you write it in a fraction form and then simplify it out by cancelling. Okay, so we're just going to go jump straight in and do some examples. That's the best way to understand how to go about doing this. Okay, so the first example we'll do will be 5 times 4g. All right, so first thing we do is expand this out by adding in our hidden multiplication symbols. So that'd be 5 times 4 times g. And our numbers and variables are already grouped together. So all I have to do is multiply this out. And 5 times 4 is 20. And 20 times g is g. 20g. So b, we'll do another one. Negative 3d times 6ab. I'll draw a B like that, times 7. Okay, so negative 3 times D, added in my hidden multiplication symbol between those two numbers there, times 6 times A times B times 7. So all I've done is I've taken our three terms, split it all up by adding in all our hidden multiplication symbols. All right. And now I can group my numbers and variables together. So it'd be negative 3 times 6 times 7. And then whatever variables I have left times A times B and times D. Now all I have to do is multiply these all together. So negative 3 times 6 equals negative 18. Negative 18 times 7 will equal, we'll write that out again, times A times B times D. Negative 18 times 7 will equal negative 126. And then negative 126 times our variables A, B, D. All right, we'll do another example now looking at some for division. So example 2. So for division, we can do 16f divided by 4. All right, so why we do that is we write in fraction form. So how we do that is we put 16f over 4, and then we just cancel out. So how many times we need to find the highest common factor of both 4 and 16, which would be 4. So how many times does 4 go into 4? 4 go into 4 once. How many times does 4 go into 16? 4 go into 16 4 times. So the answer would be 4f over 1, which is the same thing as 4f. Right. Now if I do 15n divided by 3n. All right, so we write in fraction form, so 15n over 3n. All right, and now what we do is we cancel out. So what is the highest common factor that'll fit into 3 and 15 evenly? Okay, that would be 3. All right, so how many times does 3 go into 3? 3 goes to 15. 3 goes to 3 once. How many times does 3 go into 15? 3 will go into 15 5 times. All right. Now I can also cancel out my n's. So the highest factor of that will fit into n and n evenly is n. So how many times does n go into n? Once. How many times does n go into n? Once. So this can be written as 5 times 1 over 1 times 1. All right. 5 times that means it's 5 over 1. And 5 over 1 is just 5.